This episode of The Direction is brought to you by Mist Utility. Know what's below, call before you dig. You're having as much fun as I am.
I'm having a blast, man. This is too fun. This is too fun right here.
Look at that.
That's what you come to St. Clair for right there, baby.
Kash Daniels. And that's singular with no S,
yeah,
right?
No S. Man, we're sight fishing in June.
In the wrong state.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be doing this back home. Bows up on it. Look at here.
That's a good one too, boys.
Boy, you got it. That is bowed up. Oh my goodness.
That's a good one.
Everyone has a story. Sometimes it's about catching monster bass.
Now that's a studly mudly, baby.
And sometimes it's about life's lessons. Every story is as unique as the person who tells it. So join us as we make some new friends, reunite with some old ones, catch a few fish, and share a story or two. I'm Mark Stowe, and this is The Direction.
Lake St. Clair is a big place, 467 square miles big, in fact. Not only is it home to crystal clear waters, but down in that clear water hides some of the biggest smallmouth bass an angler could target in the world. Mark Stowe has hauled up Kash Daniel, a former linebacker for the University of Kentucky who has grown up in the outdoors and who spends every spare minute outside of school and football on the lake or in the woods. Kash is known to deal some big hits on the field and known to catch some big bass as well.
Kash Daniel. And that's singular with no S,
yeah,
right?
No S, no
I
S.
I try to say Kash Daniels, and I say, nope, he's one guy, and he's right here with us today. And we're gonna be hitting Lake St. Clair to catch some big brown smallmouth, hopefully.
That's right.
And I know you're a big outdoorsman, big fisherman. Played your senior year here at the University of Kentucky, my home state, and you're a true hometown boy. I mean, you're right from the state of Kentucky, Paintsville?
Yeah, Paintsville, Kentucky, down in the mountains of East Kentucky, in the heart of the Appalachian Mountains. It was always a dream of mine, you know, to play for the Wildcats, and because you grew up in Wildcat country, you know, everywhere you went, even when you go to church on Sunday, somebody had their Sunday best with a UK emblem on it. So you could tell how deeply rooted the fan base was and how big of a deal it was to be, you know, a kid from Kentucky going there and putting on for his home state, and that's all it was for me. And you know, I had a great four years there, met a lot of great people, a lot of great relationships, and a lot of great memories I'll take with me for the rest of my life. But, man, I'm excited to get out here on this smallmouth, get after some other footballs besides the one I get after on the field.
There we go. Lake St. Clair, we're going to go hit the water and catch some fish.
Let's get after it, baby. Then that marker get warm for you, baby.
Good day. You already ready.
I'm ready to go, man. Let's get after it.
It's game time, right?
That's right. That's right.
And these lakes are so gorgeous when the wind ain't blowing.
Oh, I know.
Boy, it feels good out here today.
It does. I mean, wow.
All it is sand bottom.
Crazy.
Look at him. Throw at him. See him right there? See him swimming right there?
Oh, there's him right
Look
there.
Look at him. Oh, yeah, Terry, they're all over right here. Oh. Terry, what color are them smallmouth in the when you see them? I am pretty sure that's one right there. But, Look at that.
There,
right
first out cast the gate. Of the day.
First cast, baby.
Let's go. Get on up in here, baby. Let's go. Come on with me.
Hey, it ain't a giant, but it's a way to start. Right there. Toss that tube out. These mollies up here trying to spawn. They're just everywhere down there. Look at them. Okay, look at them. Dude, they're just stacked down there. See them?
Oh, that's just crazy.
They're just everywhere.
All right. Switch up to the tube.
Yeah. We're going to say I got nothing on that spinning rod there.
Yeah.
Back there, baby.
Man, we're sight fishing in June.
In the wrong state.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be doing this back home.
Nope. Man, this is crazy, though. I mean, this is awesome. See how crystal clear it is?
Oh, these lakes are beautiful.
Little one, but I'll take him though.
Hey.
I think that's a, that's smallie.
I was gonna say, that's a smallie.
Hey. Start off with that one though.
You, that's breaking the icing right there.
That's all it is.
You, to, you broke the ice, the icing.
I'm gonna see if I can do that little Scott Martin thing here. Ah, nope, only Scott can do that.
What, I haven't seen that, what is it?
Only Scott can do that. He tosses them up from the mouth. He'll catch them like this right here on the stomach and they'll slide off his hand back into the water. So Scott, thank you for teaching me that, my friend.
This segment was brought to you by Secret Lures. The secret is out.
Well, let's see. We've been out here about 5 minutes and done put three in the boat. Yep. I like it.
This is our kind of fishing right here.
The stupid tube rig is you're going through the bottom.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Then so I was thinking like Texas rig.
All right, so you're popping it out there because you gotta have enough room for the head. And you're pushing this, and it don't matter how wore out the tube gets because you're gonna go through the good part of it. So I'm gonna rotate this head around and I'm gonna pop it through in a good spot, like right there. You wanna rotate the head.
Okay.
You know, like this. Then you tear it through, then you take it, and you stick it back through. And really, the better the tube gets wore,
better off it's gonna
be. It is, yep. As long as you have good part of the head left.
Okay.
You know, and then you just retie.
That's a good one.
Hooked up.
That's a good one.
Oh, yeah. I don't think there's gonna be showing you anything about any smallmouth fishing.
I got my feet wet in a little bit.
I like it. Now he's going down tournament style here.
And I'm gonna get my third fish landing violation today. There we go.
And look at that. That's a pretty smallie.
These are beautiful fish, man.
They are beautiful.
They hit good, they fight good, and they're just really pretty looking. All right, come on.
They are definitely my favorite, and this place is one of my favorites. What'd you say your personal best smallie was?
5'2".
5'2", that's a good smallmouth. So how'd you get into fishing?
Well, so fishing for me was implemented at a really young age, ever since I could, you know, barely remember. I mean, I see pictures of my dad when I was just, you know, 6, 7, 8 months years old out there in a boat with him. And then he would tell me stories of how he would have to sometimes go out there and change my diaper in the boat. And he wouldn't make, you know, real long runs or anything, so he wouldn't worry the family too much. He just wanted to, you know, get me into it at a young age. And this is something that, you know, I fell in love doing with my dad. And you know, I just took it as my own little hobby. Fishing has always been a big part of my life. And
so you and Dad did that a lot together?
Me and Dad, yep. My dad, oh, there's a big one right there.
I'm gonna get a fluke out here in a second. Boat up. Look here.
That's a good one.
That is a nice chunk there. Look at that. Look at him fight. Kash, I think you're showing your real colors, man. I think fishing's the deal here with you. Smallie come out. Isn't it funny how they want to run up under that boat like that, that shadow, and they just like to stick their heads up under there. Oh yeah, baby. Putting the smallies in the boat. Hang on, let me snap a social media pic while we're at it. Son, you're just like making this look easy.
Hey, it's that easy right there. I mean, it's... These are little fish, but man, I'm having so much fun catching these things. I can catch these things all day.
Hey, I'm like a spectator. I'm sitting in the, I got my good fan seat checking. Yeah, here you go, knocking them out, man. Oh. We get on here and with the direction and, you know, take somebody like you. You know, everybody sees the football player. They see the linebacker that wants to go tear the guy's head off and stop that guy from scoring. But then there's, you know, like I said, the side of, you know, how were you raised? You know, how'd you get into hunting and fishing? And,
yep.
You know, I like the real person aspect of it, because the problem with a television camera is it kind of sometimes can take you and puts a spotlight on somebody.
Right, absolutely.
But behind that spotlight is a true individual, you know, still a person.
Right.
Still got feelings, still got emotions, still has to work hard to get where you're at.
Absolutely.
I mean, to earn that spot on that team that you had, I mean, I would hate to know the commitment, the time, the work ethic that goes into that.
You got class, you got workouts, treatment, everything rolls in on top of each other. It's a busy schedule, and my dad always told me, because since he played Division I athletics, he said, if you can go there, you can do this, and you can thrive in it, there's nothing in this world you can't handle. Because of everything that's thrown on top of you, one by one by one, right, stacked right on top of each other. You got to persevere, got to find time to balance out your time. So, okay, I got to get this done for class. I got to get this done for sports. But at the same time, you know, you got to have a little time for yourself and be social, meet new people and things like that. And that's the really hardest part, you know, is just finding that time and then fishing. So, you know, a lot of people, you know, like a lot of people, you know, in athletics have different, you know, releases, you know, to release, you know, their stress or anything like that. Some guys, you know, they just like to hang out and play Xbox, you know, and that's cool.
Yep.
You know, some guys, you know, they do different things. But for me, whenever I can get a 2 hours or 2.5 hours or an hour, you know, out on a farm pond back in Lexington and a turkey blind in the morning before I got to go to class, you know, I'm going to take that opportunity just because, you know, I know that's something that brings me joy and that brings me my release of, you know, all the stress that may be going on in my life and things like that. So ultimately, that's what I'm most wanting to introduce to everybody, is just have that feeling of being able to come out here and just go, whew, and just catch it.
You wouldn't get caught out on the lake without your favorite bait. So why would you get caught digging without calling 811?
Are you getting ready to start your own digging project? Be sure to call 811 and get your underground utilities located. It's the law and it's free.
Here, try this. This segment is brought to you by PowerPole. Swift, silent, secure. Yeah, y'all want to learn how to fish the stupid tube correctly? All we gotta do is watch right here. I just stand and I watch.
This is too fun.
Bows up on it, look at here.
That's a good one too, boys.
Boy, you got it. That bowed up. Oh my goodness.
That's a good one.
Oh yeah. Woo-hoo. Oh, look at that. Look at this.
Doubled up,
my rod's laying on the deck. So.
Alexa, play Double Up by Nipsey Hussle. Please. Belly lifting.
Oh my goodness, look at the back on that fish. Yeah. Hey, we see who the star of this show is right there, baby. Oh my.
Here we go. That's what we're after up there. About a three, pushing three.
Oh, what a pretty fish.
Absolutely, what a pretty fish.
Whew. St. Clair, man. I told you it wasn't nothing like it.
I know. Oh, this is awesome.
Oh, it's crazy. I like more steam yards, but I like my bait casters. Oh, look at here. I'm going to go under you.
Yep. Come on here, big boy.
He's going for the shadow of that boat.
Come on up in here, big boy.
Oh, look at that.
I mean, I've never seen anything like these fish fight like that.
Hey.
They don't want to be caught, that's for
no.
Sure.
No, sir.
Right, top of the mouth. Right where you want. Boom.
That. Hey. He's been stupid too.
That's right.
Look at this. Yeah. Look at that. We got the Kash Daniels Bass Fishing Show right here.
I'm going to race a trail motor now.
Y'all need a host of a show right there. This guy comes with the stories, the heart, and the fishing techniques. Look at that smallie, son.
Woo! You'd have been a boat.
Look at the smile on this guy's face.
I love these smallies, man.
I think I found something you like to do as much as hitting somebody. Oh, I'm loving it. Coming together. Them last couple have been nice ones.
Absolutely.
So, are you a Stupid Foot Tube fan now?
Big Stupid Tube fan.
Everything that you played high school football wise and bass or college wise, what favorite moment?
Man, there's so many moments that, and they're different moments. You got game moments, you got moments that where you just connect as a team. That's hard to put because I have so many good memories. I mean, we beat Florida in the swamp to end the streak. So, there you go. Oh, he came off.
No, he ain't. Now, come on,
He spit it out. I thought it.
I'm enjoying the moment, man.
I saw that line, that bait up on that line. Good little one right there. Pretty good.
Hey.
Oh, they're so fast.
And they are. And they don't stop.
It's like a torpedo going through the water.
They are. They're just so quick. He just come and whops that fluke. Look at that. Love them bronze back fish. Look at that.
There we go.
Low smallie. Kiss goodbye. This segment is brought to you by Jinko Fishing. It's all about the action. You know what's crazy? You think about these little seawalls right here. That is all that's holding that island together.
Really?
Is that little seawall. Well, think about it. It's seawalled in.
Ain't going nowhere.
And that sand, that's all sand up there. That's 3 casts in a row I got bit right there.
There you go.
There just wads of them. Hey, let me show you something. See what rod I went back there?
Hey, say, bait caster, baby.
I can't do it. Man, I'm half as good with a spinning rod. Let's throw on that drop shot. And there ain't nothing like them old brown fish up here. Football, man. I just love them little short, stocky. They just, man, nothing like it. Good old Ned rig right there.
That's right.
Little TRD on it. Now it's time for your safe digging moment of the week, brought to you by 811. Always remember to call before you dig. Our 811 moment of the week has got to be Kash Daniels catching just big numbers of smallmouth bass. This guy proves that he's not only a Division I college athlete, but he's a Division I bass fisherman as well. You having as much fun as I am?
I'm having a blast, man. This is too fun. This is too fun right here.
Nice.
That's a good one there, boys.
That's a good one.
Come on, big boy.
Oh my.
Come on, big boy.
You got you a good one right there. I mean a good one. Right there, son. I'm coming to you. No. Oh, butt's gonna.
I got this one.
You got it?
Yeah.
You're gonna have to belly her right there. Look at her. Oh, she's a beauty.
Come on, man. Come on, man.
Look at that St. Clair's Molly right there, Cash. That's the deal, son. Right there.
On,
that right there is what we come here for. Pretty fish like that. Oh my God.
Oh, come here, baby.
Look at that.
That's what you come to St. Clair for right there, baby.
That's a
right
fish.
There. That's pushing four.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Stupid tube, baby. Stupid tube.
Oh. I just sit here in this boat and laugh and smile, catching fish.
Oh, yeah.
Look at
him. He's been through battles.
Yeah, see where she spawned and see her tail.
Yeah.
And then she's headed back out. And what it is, we're just sitting here on this point and the fish are just moving back out.
Yeah.
Well, Kash, I don't know about you, my friend, but it's been a fun day. Yeah. There's nothing like catching these big brown fish up here on St. Clair.
Nothing like it.
I mean, until you've been northern smallmouth fishing, I mean.
You ain't been smallmouth fishing.
You haven't.
No.
No.
Yeah.
I look forward to coming up here every time I get the chance, and get to bring you up here is pretty awesome. And
man, I've had an awesome time. Came up here, you got me on the stupid tube. Came up here and became a tube expert by the end of the day. So I appreciate you. I appreciate the guys from 811 and what they do for you in this show. And thank you.
Well,
I appreciate
it's been
you,
a privilege being a boat with you. I love your enthusiasm. I love what you bring to folks about life in general. I mean, you know, just show people that passion and love and for football, for the outdoors, and just in everything you do, man, it is a gift to pass on to, you know, the youth out there.
I appreciate you, brother. Thank you very much.
So, all righty, sir. Well, unfortunately, every good day's got to come to an end.
Yep.
The Direction is brought to you by 811. Know what's below, call before you dig. We would also like to thank these fine partners. Closed captioning is brought to you by USA North. Call 811 before you dig.